Okay, this sermon is entitled, "Those Who Insist on a Changed Life Are False Converts, a.k.a. Goats." I'd like to open up with prayer and then with a few verses. All right, dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners, I ask all this in Jesus' name, amen. Psalm 19 reads, "The heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament sheweth his handiwork. Day unto day uttereth speech, and night unto night sheweth knowledge. There is no speech nor language where their voice is not heard." Now before I get into the sermon, I'd like to preface about what I'm talking about here. There are false prophets out there that try to claim that when a person is saved, they have a physical transformation or a transmogrification. And they try to say that you have a new life, a new desires, new thoughts, and all these are resultant of being born again. When in reality, the Bible makes it very clear that as Christians, we have a dual or a dichotomous nature. We have the spirit and the flesh, and they're at a constant battle, like a spiritual fisticuffs or whatever. But in reality, the flesh does not change one bit. And the only thing we can do as Christians who have the Holy Spirit indwelling us is we can grow in grace, we can mature spiritually, but this whole nonsense about your flesh changing upon salvation or upon conversion is complete. It's just that. It's nonsense. It's garbage. It doesn't happen at all. And what these people are actually teaching is something like, let's just say you used to smoke cigarettes, and the cigarettes tasted really nice and sweet and delectable. Then all of a sudden you get saved. Now the cigarettes taste like denatonium benzoate or, you know, Bitrix or turpentine or some type of a poison, and it's like you just don't crave it anymore. Or you used to watch television, and now it's like it blinds your eyes. It's so horrible. That's not the case at all. The flesh does not change one bit, and salvation is not physical. It's spiritual, 100%. And I'm not against this notion of growing and gradually or piecemeal changing after you're saved, but this whole teaching that says if you're truly saved, there will be a changed life as evidence is garbage. Number one, because that changed life doesn't actually happen. It never transpires. It never occurs upon salvation. And the reason why people think it does is because they're lost. They're false converts. They're deluded. And that's what they're trusting in, their changed life. They're not trusting in Jesus Christ dying on the cross for their sins. They're not trusting in God's grace. They're not trusting in the blood of Jesus. They're trusting in themselves. And a lot of people will say, well, no, we're trusting in Jesus, but the changed life will always be there. Well, if it has to be there, then that's what you're trusting in. That's what you're adding to the gospel. Now let's take a look at John chapter 1. It makes it clear that God is the one who saves, and he alone saves. He doesn't need our help, and he doesn't need a changed life on our part. Okay? To either be saved, stay saved, or prove we're saved, none of it. John chapter 1, look at verse 13, "Which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God." That tells us right there, we're not born again by what we do in the flesh. Turn over to Titus chapter 3. Now, when a person teaches this stupid changed life doctrine or insists that the changed life will come, this negates or this disallows spiritual growth. Because here's what they're thinking. They're thinking, I'm either going to change naturally, automatically, and if it hasn't happened, I'm not really saved. And if I am growing, then, or if I am changed, then I don't need to grow. Because it's just going to automatically happen. There's no motivation to get into the Word of God and grow spiritually if it's an automatic change. So what that's all this does is it actually causes people to not grow, to not mature in the faith. And see, all these stupid false prophets that teach this, just take a look at their lives, okay? Just give them a scrutiny. Have they really changed? A lot of these people that teach this are overweight. Okay, they're just very sorry, ridiculous, stupid people. They don't change in what they believe. They don't change in what they teach because it's all garbage. It's all farcical. Okay, no change has actually taken place in these people's lives. It's foolish. I've never met a person that's actually changed who believes this junk. Okay, in fact, they've gotten worse, most of them. But in Titus chapter 3, we see that salvation is a work of God completely. It reads in verse 5, "Not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saved us by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost." Salvation is a spiritual act of God himself. It's not by works. It's not by anything we do. It's by the Holy Ghost. Okay? So watch out for these false prophets. I've never met one person who taught this. A changed life will automatically be there. You have to have a changed life to prove you're saved. I've never met one person that was actually saved that believed that junk. None of them have believed that it's all by grace, through faith alone, in Christ alone. It's always, you know, repent of your sins, you know, obey the commandments. It's all these things that you have to do, and then they try to claim that that's just the work. That's just God working through you. It's garbage. The truth is we're saved by grace, through faith alone, in Christ alone, and then after we're saved, we're called to do good works. We're called to obey. We're called to grow, but it's volitional. It's not automatic like these unsaved false prophets are teaching. That's all I have. Let me go ahead and close in prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving us your clear word. Thank you for allowing us to see what it says. Bless the listeners. I ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.